Dubai announced its vision to be the capital of the Islamic economy globally. And with that role, we would like to play the leading role with the Islamic economy. It's, of course, it's a journey and started. And when you look at the different indicators of all the different pillars, United Arab Emirates and Dubai are ranked in the top comparing to others. Again, as we said, a lot of things has to be done to continue our role to play a leading role. But one thing is very important to keep in mind that this is a new area and there is a lot of things to do. And we believe that the different hubs, whether it is London in Europe or Malaysia in Asia, has to complement with each other to be able to deal with the challenges to take this Islamic economy discussions and area forward. The global halal tourism industry is around $140 billion. That's 12% of the global spending in tourism. And Dubai is one of the fastest tourism cities around the world and has a big vision going forwards with 20 million tourists by year 2020. And we see this area as one of the areas already the city of Dubai is leading with tourism and can lead with halal tourism in that area. When you look, of course, at Dubai, we've been doing quite well when it gets to tourism, and we understand it quite well, and we believe that many things can be done to address this important area. Dubai can contribute a lot from its experience. And when you look at this size, this is very sizable industry that needs to be addressed going forwards. We identified the area of Islamic fashion as one of the areas that has a lot of potentials going forwards. We believe by working together and focusing in these sectors, many opportunities can be identified and developed going further. The Global Islamic Economy Summit this year will continue focusing in the vision of Dubai to be capital of the Islamic economy. We'll focus on the Islamic finance, halal food, the Sharia compliance, tourism, standardization, the issue of arts and culture, and the education. We still believe there is a long way to go in the global standardization of the halal foods and products. This issue started to be addressed in the past few years, and we realize there are challenges because you have to align many different economies, many different countries, and different standards. Of course, the good thing, the discussion already started, and in Dubai, we start focusing more and more to lead with this issue. We have in Dubai municipality some efforts already started, and a lot of dialogue started also with different authorities in leading countries, such as Saudi Arabia and Malaysia. And we hope during our summit, we'll be able to discuss a lot of what we achieved and the way forwards. However, we still believe there is a long way to go. One thing we realized with the Islamic economy, there is a shortage of information. And one thing we start to address in partnership with a number of providers such as Thomson Reuters is the content and issue more research. And through our partnership in the Global Islamic Economic Summit, we've been issuing reports and updating them in the size of the expenditures, what can be done, and understanding more and more of the economy and the subsectors of the economy. Also, one important thing is to showcase what can be done and the opportunities, and that's where the private sector, by understanding more, they can definitely contribute more to the Islamic economy and taking it further.